As I stand here today with our symbol of pride, the pride flag unfurling behind me, I want to delve into the multifaceted nature of identities and labels. Emblazoned across our hearts and our minds is a single word, queer. This word, once heavy with negativity and scorn, now stands tall as a representation of self-acceptance, resilience, and community. But what is it truly? An identity? A label? Or perhaps both? Labels have a tendency to constrict, to be restrictive. Their very nature is prone to generalization. This is strikingly apparent in the queer community, where individuals have often been stigmatized and ostracized based on the labels that a society has assigned to them. In many instances, labels like queer have been weaponized, transformed into tools of repression, rather than expressions of individuality. We cannot forget Section 28, a law introduced into the UK in 1988 that forbade the promotion of homosexuality in our schools. The term queer was often used as an insult, a harmful label designed to belittle and demean. But in the face of such adversity, the queer community has shown immense resilience. We've seized those labels. We've flipped them on their heads. We've reclaimed queer as a term of power, of self-identity and unity. Much like a phoenix, the term has risen from the ashes of its past derogatory usage and is now a symbol of empowerment and defiance. And here lies the inherent beauty of the term queer. Unlike a label, it doesn't impose a rigid, uniform mould. It provides an inclusive umbrella, a safe haven under which a multitude of individuals can find acceptance. Acknowledging the diverse range of sexual and gender identities that exist. However, we must tread with caution. Stereotypes often lurk in the shadow of labels, casting dark and distorting silhouettes that reduce individuals to mere caricatures. Who can forget that old cliche of the flamboyant gay man? It's a stereotype born out of a label, simplifying a rich, complex identity into an easily digestible trope. This pride flag represents more than just a symbol. It's a kaleidoscope of identities. Each colour represents a different facet of the queer community. The diversity encapsulated within this single term is its strength, but also a double-edged sword. As we cluster together under this umbrella, we risk obscuring the unique experiences that each colour of the flag signifies. So as we step into Pride Month, let us pause and reflect. Let us remember the power of words, their potential to harm and to oppress. Also, let's reclaim and empower. Be aware of the potential for stereotypes and groupings to erase individual experiences. Recognize that whilst we may share a label, our identities are uniquely our own, as varied and beautiful as the colours of our pride flag. Look at this flag behind me. I don't see just a label. I see my identity, my pride, my resilience. And I hope, as we celebrate Pride this month, we continue to see each other beyond the labels, appreciating the unique identities that define us. In the end, let us remember this. We are not just queer. We are individuals with our own stories, our own identities. And that is worth infinitely more than any label could ever capture. Thank you. My name is Joanne Lockwood. I am an inclusive culture expert with See Change Happen. Stay inclusive.